My name is Jeff. I'm 39 years old. I'm from West Palm Beach, Florida. Ugh. And I have a huge hump on my spine. It has been with me for about 10 years now.
Whoa.
What?
That's the little small bump from last time?
Yeah, man, it's all right. I call myself the Hunchback of Palm Beach County. When I feel it, it's just very tight. I first noticed this, it went from a gumball to a tennis ball, and now it's a grapefruit. I run a company that builds decks and docks. That's my bread and butter. The bump has become bigger and bigger, and when I'm working, I can always feel pain. Any type of movement that requires me to look left or right, definitely, I can feel pain.
What is that?
It's just a big hump.
It ain't hard for you to work like that?
I've seen two doctors that said that it could have been a lipoma. But right now, I'm very busy running a family business. And the procedure is scary as well. A lot of things could happen, like becoming paralyzed. So I'm definitely scared. Although I do strive to be a confident guy, internally, I hide and mask my real feelings and emotions. This bump makes me feel like there's something wrong with me. That's why I try to work out all the time. I try to eat well, but internally, it does mess with me. So in my past, before it has gotten the size that it is now, I was super confident. I can go out, talk to any woman with ease, but the lump is definitely affecting my dating life. I don't date as much as I would love to date. It's definitely taking away that ability to go out there and entertain. So this bump affects me in a lot of different ways. And most of all, it affects my ability to be a productive father. I have four kids. I have three daughters and one son. They are the loves of my life.
What?
What are you doing? You playing?
Yes.
Okay. My youngest daughter, Amaya, she comes here on the weekends, and it's been on my back her whole entire life. So she knows that Daddy has a camel back.
Yay.
Okay. 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 Now that put a lot of strain on Daddy back, Daddy. I live for my kids, you know, I work for my kids, I do everything in my ability for my kids. But with this huge hump on my back, it's causing a lot of mental stress.
Oh my goodness.
Let's go up here, Daddy.
Dating right now has been a challenge. Girls look at me, but they won't look at me once they see this. I don't have that same confidence anymore, that self-esteem.
This is why we have to do something about this.
Yeah, yeah. I'm just super scared because I don't know what can happen. I'm not a doctor, you know, I'm a carpenter. But I need it to be removed because it causes a lot of problems.
When you have fullness on your upper back area, right below your neck, that can be a lipoma, but that can also be other things. I've certainly seen dorsal cervical fat pads. It's also called buffalo hump. We name it that because it looks like the hump on a buffalo. There's a lot of other conditions that have animal-type descriptors. Elephantiasis just means like an enlarged part of the skin. I mean, there's a fawn-tailed nevus that is potential spinal dysraphism. Fish scale, like you see with ichthyosis. People can have a turkey neck. Buffalo hump is something that I tend to see more commonly. So the first thing for me to do, really, when I hear somebody that has a growth in the back, is really add this to the differential. So how long have you had this bump on you?
It's been around 10 years.
10 years,
10
okay.
Years. It started off as a gumball at first, and uh-huh. Over the period of time, it just grew.
Have you seen any doctors for this before?
I have.
Okay.
Doctor told me it was a lipoma. She dealt with them. The position of where it is mm-hmm. got me really worried because I don't know if it can paralyze me, a nerve or something,
scary.
If it grows and grows. So I don't know what will happen if it continues to grow.
If you don't mind, I'm going to take a look at it. I might touch and feel it, if that's okay. Yeah. If you don't mind, okay? Yeah. So let me just take a look. Well, it does feel like a lipoma, because it really is pretty mobile. It moves around really well, which is a good sign. It's not really in the center of your spine. It's off to the side, which is good, too, because, you know, obviously in the center, that we'd be more concerned with a direct connection there. Jeff's lipoma feels nice and mobile, so that's a good thing. This can be a tricky, very frustrating area to work on, but I have pretty high hopes on this. I feel pretty good about this one. Well, this looks like a lipoma, most likely. I'm never completely positive until I start removing something.
Yeah.
But they're benign. It's just sometimes they just kind of grow bigger and bigger. Not only can they put pressure on nerves or vessels or cause soreness, they're also a source of embarrassment, right? So I'm gonna try to remove this in as gentle a way as possible, okay?
Okay, all right. Dr. Lee tells me that the lipoma isn't directly over my spine as I thought it was. So I was really ecstatic that I got that news from her.
Ready?
Yes. Yes, I am. A little scared a little bit. At the same time, I feel nervous because needles. I do not love needles.
First, I'm gonna actually put some numbing and let it sit for a little bit.
No needles.
Okay. Well, I'm very gentle, first of all. You know that my nickname is Painless Lee.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Jeffrey is pretty afraid of needles. I mean, I hope that I can keep him nice and calm and get him nice and numb. And I realize now that I have to contend with his nerves and I don't want him to panic. I feel like this is the hardest thing to manage here in this case. Actually, we're not really using a needle. We're using a little cannula, and that actually makes us a lot more comfortable. And it doesn't actually feel as bad as a needle.
I do not love needles at all. Just the mere thought of one entering my body, just, it makes me shiver. But I gotta be a warrior right now.
You might feel just one little baby pinch here, okay? A little baby pinch here. How you doing, okay?
Yeah.
That wasn't too bad, was it?
I felt it.
You did? Yeah. Uh-oh, are we gonna put you in that DF category, the delicate flower category? I do think we improved it a good amount, but I couldn't get it all out. I hate it. I don't like it when this happens, and it happens very rarely, but like it happens. But pretty soon, once that swelling settles down, it will look a lot better. It is swollen right now. There's definitely numbing in there that makes it look fuller, but it was really hard to get off the deeper component. I flattened it a good degree, but down underneath, there were like all these little fingers projecting like nuts. Really hard for me to pull up because they were like wedged in there. Mm-hmm. So we're crossing our fingers. I think it's gonna get smaller than this, but I hope it doesn't come back. That's the whole goal.
Oh, man.
It is better.
It's a lot better.
Still see a bump, but it looks...
Yeah, it's a lot smaller than it once was. Right now, my back look amazing. I didn't see my back this way for 10 years, so I feel amazing right now. And now that my bump is gone, it's a new chapter to my life. There's gonna be a lot of changes inside of my life once I get home.
You're awesome.
Thank you.
I'll be checking on you, and it was so nice to meet you. Take care, okay? We'll be in touch. Thank you.
I feel really good right now, and I thank Dr. Lee for all the hard work that she put in. I know it was a really tough procedure for me, but she was able to make me calm, and 80 to 90% that she was able to get out, you know, is a lot smaller than what it once was. I'm happy with that.